Hey, what's up, guys? Nerdz aka Joe, and I'm doing another Habit of Bridge episode, and I'm actually going to be combining the two kids, Brawler and Archer, because there's not too much I can actually say about these kids. But if anything, we're going to be clearing up a few misconceptions made about each kit, for example, like its use. So, as you probably heard me complain millions and millions of times while recording, is about the brokenness of Brawler. Now, if there ever was a kit that's a bit more broken than Appler, it's definitely Brawler. So what exactly makes Brawler so broken? First of all, you start off with an Iron Sword, which isn't that broken at all. You deal 125% KB, takes 75% less KB, and one less damage. So in which case, this kit is probably the best kit for PvP. Okay, moving on. With Archer, you get a bow that's unbreakable, though I don't think it would ever break. You get one arrow per 20 seconds, and the max you can carry of these fletched arrows is 3. Also, by pulling back on your bow, you can use your ability called Barrage, which allows you to shoot more than one arrow. So, here's the thing about Brawler. Now, seeing as this kit is very, 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 very well adept for combat, it's not very well adept for range. For example, archers, Applers, or anybody with any type of projectile can bring down a Brawler easily. They just have to stay at a distance from it, and their kit's basically useless. Now, if I were to give out my personal spew of, like, how I would properly use Brawler, for example, this video is going to be a little bit shorter because there's not much I can say about these two kits. There's just one basic strategy I used to do all the time when I would run Brawler. It's go for the strongest guy in the game. For example, like, you would want to go for the tanks because you can get their armor, and a full-time Brawler is pretty much the most OP thing in the game. And typically, it'll just snowball the game. You won't have to put too much strategy into the gameplay, considering that it'll be a tough enough challenge for even two irons to fight you and your full diamond brawler. Okay, so archers. Now, some typical strategies I've thought about with this is that I actually used to play archer a lot when I was playing solo, but I don't play it as much because berserker is obviously better. And archers typically should try to distance themselves from players. You can use the maximum extent of your kit, basically. If good enough, you can actually hit all the arrows from your barrage into one player. And it does the full damage, so this is probably something you probably should aim for. Also, typically, when you're archer, you want to try to get to these angles on the maps. For example, I know commonly, I know whenever I'm playing with Cavs on this map, on the map Skylands, we do something called the Cavs methods where we stand in Skybase with a bow on Yellow Island and we get the perfect angle to shoot anybody that goes to mid. Angles like that are gonna make this kit very good in like comp especially and like lots of bridge games. Also, something that I used to do a lot is that I would do this thing called a Cypher Shot. Now why I was given this name is because 2 years ago when I met Leon Hurt Gaming, aka I call her Cypher. She came up with, now I've been told by countless others that they had figured out the strategy before, but I'm saying off of how I figured it out, she came up with it from how I figured it out. It's basically to position yourself under a sky base and aim for their feet. So what this basically does, typically when you're playing a game and you're sky basing, you want to stay away from the edge even if you need to F5 and see who's below you. The reason why is because when your foot is shot, which is basically what's sticking out when you're F5ing, players under you that have a bow have a chance to break your shift and knock you off. This is probably something you can use on any, you can use this strategy on any map or just like get, basically what the principle of this strategy is to get under the player, shoot their feet, and make them take all the fall damage. So, and last but not least, with the bridge, we do have to do the kit nerf slash buffs. I do feel like Brawler isn't that broken. It's not super broken, but it needs a nerf, definitely. All kits do. A nerf or a buff, some type of adjustment. So with Brawler, you, in my opinion, the initial KB dealt, the initial KB should be 110%, just so they can't deal that OP amount of KB, and just so that they don't get the kit completely destroyed. That's the thing I really want to avoid when I'm doing this. Also, the KB taken should be, they take 90% KB, which is 10% less. And the initial KB take, I mean, the initial damage taken should be 0.5 less, so that it's still a decent amount of KB taken, still an initial amount of KB dealt, still an initial amount of damage not taken, so it still is the tanky kit that everybody's come to love, just a little bit less OP in its base state. So, let's talk about Archer. If anything, Archer is a really balanced kit. I just feel like, As I mentioned in a video before, Bridge 99 to be exact, is that all the kits, the goal of Game Insights, in my opinion, should not be to like nerf every single decent kit in the game, but to make every other kit that's not as used useful to the gameplay. Now, however, with Archer, it's a little bit of the opposite. I don't really feel like the kit needs to be nerfed. If anything, it's a really good kit, but I feel like all the other kits should be, in a way, given a buff to where they're actually useful in the same circumstances those kit would be useful in. But with Archer, the buff I provided for them would be fletched 1 per 20, keep the same, because I feel like that's really balanced. However, as it is super annoying, it is so annoying to only have 3 arrows to shoot off of. I know that by experience from playing Archer in scrims. I feel like a fletched of 10 would be reasonable. Now hear me out on this. The reason why I say 10 fletched is because a max of 10 fletched so that you don't have to just go off of 3 arrows so that you have more than 3 arrows when the bridges spawn, because it's really annoying to only have 3 arrows. Kit upgrades. Now let's talk about Brawler. For level 10, I feel like you should get the 1.0 damage back. For example, with all of these kits that are just, I expect might get nerfed somehow. I'm gonna be pretty mad if Appler doesn't get a nerf, but if Brawler is to get a nerf, I feel like this would be a decent nerf. And I feel like slowly and slowly, all the broken parts should come back. So 1.0 damage, that wasn't really broken, but I feel like it needed some type of nerf. At level 10, so it's not hard to get all that back. At level 30, the KB taken should be 80% so that it's reduced just a bit. So that it's reduced just a bit and it's getting close to the 75% mark. Level 50, the KB dealt should be 125%, just going back to the old state. Level 80, a diamond sword, because I feel like at level 80 for like all of these kits, this is the basic algorithm I had set up, is that they receive some type of new item or something that like gives them a little bit more of an edge for having such high level. Level 100, each kill gives a player strength for 5 seconds. This would only add to the name Brawler, because Brawler, blah blah blah, you're fighting in a bunch. And I'm just thinking, when I'm making all these changes, I'm thinking about how this is gonna affect competitive. So I'm not sure if they would purposely let the Brawler feed on kills. But however, the strength wouldn't stack like Bloodlust and Champions, but it'd merely reset every 5 seconds every time they get a kill. But it would merely reset back to 5 seconds so that it's not stackable. As for Archer, for level 10, I feel like they get 1 arrow per 15 seconds, which allows them to get 4 arrows per minute, which is pretty good. For level 30, their max fletch for their arrows, however, should be 15 for fletch, not in total. For level 50, they would get 1 per 12 seconds, so that would allow them to get 5 arrows per minute, which is seemingly OP, but it's good for Archer. Let's see, as for level 80, arrows deal plus 1 every 25 blocks traveled. I couldn't really think of an efficient item to give archers. Can you imagine how often a freaking archer would get targeted just so they can get their power 1 bow? So yeah, per 25 blocks traveled, sort of like, no, it exactly is like long shot, except not as OP. Every 25 blocks travel would be plus 1 damage on the arrow. As for level 100, and as for each kill, if you guys ever remember this famous bug, I remember Colfix actually caught a clip of this, of where arrows would bounce from player to player. It's just like Enchanter and One in the Quiver, and I feel like it would be a cool effect to add to bridges if they let arrows bounce from player to player. Okay, so those are the kit upgrades and all that, and I hope you guys did enjoy this Archer and Brawler video. It was long overdue, and I'm sorry I didn't push this out sooner. But yeah, that's going to do it for this How to Bridge. If you enjoyed, give me a like, comment, and subscribe to see more. Be sure to tell others about the series. And yeah, this is Nerdz telling you to stay awesome. Subscribe, of course. Have a nice game.